Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he came in the masjid. He came in the masjid. And he saw a man in the masjid. And this man, he's seen him a few times. More than once. More than once, he's seen him inside the masjid. And not, of course, he sees the Sahaba radiallahu anhu majma'in in the masjid at times of salah. But this man, he's seeing him when there's no salah. Dhuhr is finished, everyone's gone. Asr is not here yet, but the man's sitting there. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went up to the man and he said, Mali ya Aba Umama. O Abu Umama, what is it that I see you sitting inside the masjid when there is no salah? What is it that I see you? Why is it that I see you? Humumun lazimatni wa duyunun ya Rasulallah. Messenger of Allah, worries have taken over me and debts have overburdened me, Messenger of Allah. That is why I'm in the masjid and there is no salah, but I have turned to who? Turned to who? Come on. Allah. Humumun lazimatni wa duyunun ya Rasulallah. Worry I have and debts I have and I don't know what to do, so I'm just sitting here. Messenger of Allah says, Oh Abu Umama, I'm going to teach you some words to the nearest meaning of what he said. Okay? These words, if you read them after Maghrib and if you read them after Fajr, then Allah will take care of your worries and Allah will take care of your debts. Allahu Akbar. Oh Abu Umama, you will say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-hazan. Allahumma. Inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-hazan. Oh Allah, I am seeking your protection from worry and from the future worry that I may have. One is worries that I've got from the past all the way to the present. And one is the future worry that I may have, the fears I might have. Wa a'udhu bika min al-'ajzi wal-kasal. I'm asking you, oh Allah, that you save me from becoming unable to do anything and becoming lazy. Wa a'udhu bika min al-jubni wal-bukhl. And I'm asking you, oh Allah, to save me from being a coward and save me from being stingy. Wa a'udhu bika min ghalabati ad-dayni wa qahri ar-rijal. And oh Allah, I'm asking you to save me from debts overtaking me and the wrath of men, save me from that. I'm going to say the full Arabic now in one go. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-hazan wa a'udhu bika min al-ajzi wal-kasal wa a'udhu bika min al-jubni wal-bukhl. وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ غَلَبَةِ الدَّيْنِ وَقَهْرِ الرِّجَالِ. You know why Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught him all these eight things? There's eight things he's going to ask Allah's protection. You know why? Because when Allah puts the brake on you, my brother, Allah says in the Holy Quran, لَا مَنْ جَأَ مِنَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا إِلَيْهِ. My servant, you've got nowhere else to go to, nowhere else to turn to except to return back to me. You can go to the depths of the earth and you can try and look for your solution. You can try and get big committees and big business managers to try and get your solution. You can hire the most professional people in your life to give you advice. You can employ the best people outside there who know how to run your business. But if I, as Allah, put a brake on you, you've got nowhere to turn to except to come back to me.